Hey kids, welcome to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to make baked haddock with a breadcrumb topping, a red onion and cucumber slaw, salad, and roasted vegetables. But first, we're going to wash our hands, make sure we're cleaned up.
Happy birthday to you.
Ta-da! Okay, so one of the first things we're going to do is our roasted vegetables. This is going to be our accompaniment. Yeah. And what we have is some Brussels sprouts, carrots, and broccoli. We're going to roast that up with some olive oil, some garlic balsamic vinegar. This is the Clean Slate Farm brand of garlic balsamic vinegar. Salt and pepper. We're going to toss that a little bit. We're going to put it in this pan, toss it in a 350 degree oven, and let that roast for about 25 minutes until the vegetables are soft. Now, a quick point about this pan. This is a deep pan. Normally I do this in a sheet pan. This is a black pan or dark colored pan. This is going to roast the vegetables a lot faster because its dark color is going to absorb the heat and push the heat back out on the vegetables faster. Now, having said that, let's get going here. In we go with that. We go with that. In we go with that. Put these off to the side. I'm going to add a little olive oil. And we're going to toss it a little bit. Just get them tossed and get them covered up nice. Add a little salt. And that might be, as far as salt goes, maybe a quarter to a half a teaspoon. Pepper just to cover. Give it a little toss again. Actually, let's add a little bit of the garlic balsamic here. And you see how that doesn't come pouring out? Just a little bit shakes on that. That's good. Okay. Into the pan, into the oven. So now we're going to make our salad, and that is very thinly sliced English cucumbers. The long skinny ones that come in the paper. About a cup of those, same thing on the thinly sliced red onions. You can see that's very thinly sliced. We are going to use about a half to a three quarters of a cup of rice wine vinegar, a little bit of honey, some red crushed pepper, red pepper crushed. So let's get that going. Add that to the bowl. Now what's going to happen is the rice wine vinegar is going to extract the heat out of these guys, and you don't need an awful lot of these because it'll get hot if you go too far. I'm going to use about a tablespoon of honey, and yes, this is honey from our farm. Just going to cover that up. From our bees, our apiary. What I'm going to do is add just a couple of these guys. That's about all you need. Just about a quarter of a teaspoon, if that. Maybe a dozen flakes or so. That's more than a dozen. Throw them all in. Now, as I'm whisking this, I'm going to return back to our hand washing lesson. Yeah, it wasn't 20 seconds, but you get the picture, right? Wash your hands 20 seconds. Sing happy birthday. That's about 20 seconds. Water about as hot as you can stand with soapy water. Hand soap. Okay, that's working. It's pretty much mixed together now. We're going to mix it quick because it's got a little bit left. And what this is going to get, you're going to get a sweet and sour taste out of it. It's really a great salad. Put that back in there. We're going to add this. And add this. Wow, that's a lot. A little bit more than I thought. And then we're just going to toss this. Just get everything mixed together a little bit. Okay, next, let's get the fish out and make that breadcrumb topping and get that in the oven. Alrighty, now we are ready to do the fish. Now what we have here is haddock. These fillets are about 6 to 8 ounces. One's a little bit bigger. I'm going to show you a little trick here quickly. If you have a fillet of fish and it's got the tail like that, and you see how it's like thin on one end and it's fat up at this end? Just fold it over, get an equal thickness. That way it cooks all about the same time. So, let's get some paper towel here. Okay, so we have 1 cup of breadcrumb. I'm going to do a little seasoning here with some oregano, roughly a teaspoon. That's about it, maybe half a teaspoon. A little garlic powder, about the same, about a quarter to a half a teaspoon, grind of pepper or two. Pepper makes the world go round. Gonna add a little bit of salt. Whenever you're seasoning with salt, you're looking not to taste salt, you're looking to taste just the brightness of the flavor that you're making. And then finally a little bit of parsley flake, about a tablespoon to two tablespoons. Crush that up a little bit, grind it up, and mix that. Get that mixed up, and then a little bit of lemon zest is also going on this. Maybe the zest of, let's say, half a lemon. Lemon always brightens flavors too. The trick in cooking is that when you're cooking, sometimes acids like lemon juice, orange juice, vinegar will brighten the flavors. So we're going to use the zest here. We're just going to brighten the flavor a little bit because you're going to get that nice lemon taste. We're going to use the lemon zest here. It's about the zest of a half a lemon. Looks good to me. Toss that around a little bit. Mix it up. Then it's going to get a little bit of 1/4 of a cup of melted butter. And we're going to make our topping. So I'm just going to mix that up. Butter is surprising. It's like when you're making a cheesecake and you're making the crust on the bottom. Butter absorbs quite a bit. Now I'm going to use my hands on this. It's going to be okay because this is going in the oven. All right, so I've got the pan in the oven, heating up. Here's a little trick for you as well. Whenever you're cooking a protein, meat, chicken, fish, whatever, the protein should be at room temperature. Always cook it in an oven. Do a 350 to 450 degree oven, depending upon what you're cooking. Your recipe will tell you what that is. The reason you want to cook in an oven rather than on the stovetop, especially for something like this, is because the heat from the stove radiates from all sides rather than from one side up, and then flip it, and then one side up again. Heat from the oven radiates all sides, cooks more evenly. So, now that we got that going, hot pan. Add a little bit of olive oil. Here is our breadcrumb mixture, so you can see that again. I'll show that a little bit in the camera. Okay, so nice and moist throughout. I hope you can see that. And again, that's way more than I'm gonna need here. So we're gonna put the fish in here. Doesn't matter that it's not sizzling because it's going to cook in the oven. It's going to bake. Remember, it's baked. We're going to put the breadcrumb on top. We get some breadcrumbs in the bottom. Don't worry about it. And I think this is a pretty good. I'm not a big fish person, but I really like this recipe. And I would eat fish like this a couple of times a month, if not more. So we're good there. Now this is going to go in that 350 degree oven. The recipe, original recipe, calls for about 20 to 25 minutes. This fish is going to cook a lot faster than 20 to 5 minutes. I'm going to say we're looking probably at 12 to 15 minutes. So let me get this on so you can see what that looks like. And into the oven we go. Okay, we'll be back in a few minutes with some baked fish. So we should be about finished on the fish. And I'm going to tell you the quick way to find out if your fish is done is my fish spatula. I use one of these. I like this better because I do. When you test your fish for doneness, if you push on the fish and the flakes flake apart, that's when the fish is done. You don't even have to worry if it's wet on the inside. If it does that, the minute it does that, your fish is done. It'll be nice and moist. So here's what we have. Let's grab that handle. And there's the fish. And now we're going to go over and plate it with the roasted vegetables and our salad and have dinner. Okay, so we're about ready to plate dinner. So we're going to take the vegetables. It's noisy, isn't it? Get that aluminum foil off of there. Veggies are nice and roasted. Nice hot pan. And now we can plate. And here's the fish. Want to be careful on that because that cast iron gets hot and stays hot. There's the fish. And now we can plate. So here we go. Fish over there. Now our vegetables. And now we're going to hit the veg with a little bit more vinegar. A couple of lemon wedges. and we are off to dinner. Okay, I almost forgot our salad here. So let's get that in there. There's that. And now we are good to go and ready to have dinner. And there you have it, Skaneateles haddock, or breaded haddock, baked haddock, with the breadcrumb on top. And then we have the roasted vegetables with some oil, vinegar, salt, and pepper. It's the garlic vinegar, this stuff. And our slaw, our salad, which is the thinly sliced red onion and cucumber with the rice wine vinegar, honey, and a little bit of pepper flake. We're done. Hey, thanks for watching. We really appreciate it. Don't forget we have a podcast as well. You can find it on iTunes, Stitcher, and whatever the other podcast places are. And just look for Clean Slate Farm. Thanks for watching again. We'll see you later. Dinner time. Bye-bye.